The Leonid meteor shower is a particular meteor shower that occurs around November, December of every year. And the meteors appear to come from one area on the sky. That happens near, coincidal with the constellation Leo, hence the name Leonids. And so there are many meteor showers throughout the year. This is a particular one that happens in November. So a meteor is a small particle of debris from interplanetary space, a dust grain or a small sand grain, and it impacts the Earth's atmosphere randomly, and when it does that, it's coming in at very high speed and it burns up, and we see that burning object as it travels through the atmosphere. A meteor shower is a collection of these, right? So meteors, debris and dust are randomly hitting Earth's atmosphere all the time. But a meteor shower is an event that is caused when Earth passes through the orbit of an asteroid or a comet. And asteroids or comets are dirty things. They're releasing a lot of debris, this dust and sand grains. And as the Earth's orbit passes through the orbit of that object, we encounter a higher number of meteors. And so we call that a meteor shower. It's not just a random event, but there's a larger number per hour of these meteors. The Leonid meteor shower is debris that is coming off of a comet that has a 33-year orbit as it orbits in our solar system and it passes near the Earth and around the Sun. And as it's traveling through the solar system, its debris is coming off of the surface. And so as that comet passes through the solar system, it leaves this trail. And that trail of debris remains in orbit. And as the Earth passes through that location in the solar system, we encounter a larger number of dust particles creating the meteor shower. Theoretically, you can see the meteors anywhere, but meteors are typically relatively faint. And so you really want to look for a dark site. And so if you can avoid those areas that are light polluted, you know, go to a rural area nearby your house where it's a little bit darker, and you're going to have a higher probability of being able to see these objects. Some of the meteors will be bright enough that you could see anywhere, but most of them are relatively faint. You'll be able to see them with the naked eye. Go to a dark site. This year, unfortunately, we are going to have a relatively bright moon, and that's not going to help the situation, but there's nothing we can do about that. This is the great thing about astronomy in general and meteors and meteor showers in particular. You just need your eyes, and so you can typically see them with the naked eye. Most of the particles that are coming off an asteroid or a comet are very small, dust-like. And they literally are. That's not an analogy. They are like the dust that we have around us here on Earth. They're very, very small. You might ask, why are they so bright when we see them, right, streaking through the sky? And it's because they're moving at very high velocities and they get heated up and they turn into a plasma and shine. The large fraction of material is in this very small state. Comets are certainly more active than asteroids. By definition, as they come near the Sun, they get heated up and material is blown off of their surface. And that can be water, ice crystals, dust, sand grains, and that sort of thing. Asteroids, there may be water particles, ice particles, but that's mostly rocky material. Depending on the body, you might get larger particles. And that material coming off has different elemental composition, and that might affect the color of the meteor, but generally not so much. It's more of a size issue. And so if it's a big particle, that's going to lead to spectacular, you know, meteor streams that are bright and long duration, longer duration than a typical meteor that lasts a couple of seconds.